Okay, any questions about AML before we move on? Okay. Now, juvenile xanthogranuloma, also known as solitary xanthogranuloma, or just xanthogranuloma, whatever you like, because they often occur in kids, but adults can get them too. And they're not always solitary. They can be multiple sometimes. So the classic is that they're usually in little kids. You know, about a third of them are present at birth. They're usually in kids under a year old, but I see them in adults on a regular basis, okay? And often on the head and neck, and tend to have kind of a reddish brown to yellow color to them, okay? Because of that kind of lipid content. So this is a nice example, like a diffuse dermal replacement. And you can tell from low power, these are probably going to be histiocytes or a lot of histiocytes because of how pale it is, right? A dense lymphocyte infiltrate is going to be blue because lymphocytes have a lot of nucleus and not much cytoplasm. But here, when you see a lot of pale pink or gray from low power, think about something histiocyte rich. And of course, the classic thing that you want to see are these beautiful Teuton giant cells, and usually eosinophils will be present too. So Teuton giant cells have a ring of nuclei and have a smooth kind of creamy candy filling, or, you know, like in a crunchy, crispy, foamy shell around the outside is the way. I think Ron Rapini said that once, and I loved it and I stole it from him. So I'm pretty sure I heard him say that. I hope I'm not taking his name in vain. But in any case, one of my great mentors who I'm a huge fan of. I love Ron Rapini. Just such a great dermpath and a wonderful teacher. So anyway, the Teuton giant cells are usually present. But the thing is that sometimes they're abundant and sometimes they're very sparse or even absent. The other thing is that when a Teuton giant cell looks like this, no problem, right? You got this. But look, this is a Teuton giant cell also. It's just cut kind of funny and it doesn't have a full ring of nucleus. This probably is too. We're just seeing it only like one little snip. We're like cutting across it kind of like that. And then here's one that's kind of incomplete. And look at this down here. Here's one too. So it's worth, when you see a nice JXG, spend some time learning about the different ways that Teuton giant cells can look when they're not perfect. Because when they're perfect, no problem. But when they're imperfect, then sometimes you can struggle to recognize them. And also remember that Teuton giant cells can be present in a lot of other things, including, say, dermatofibromas and other things like that. Okay. So that's nice Teuton giant cells. Here's another one. And also all the EOs came out to party with the Teuton giant cell here. That's what you want to see, right? But not every case looks like that, okay? There's a wide range of features in juvenile xanthogranuloma. Sometimes they're classic like this. Other times, not so much, okay? Sometimes they can be very fibrotic and spindled and they can look a lot like dermatofibroma. Sometimes they can have just sheets of histiocytes and not have any Teutons. Sometimes they have tons of EOs. Sometimes very few or none. And those cases can be a little bit more challenging to diagnose. So here's an example from low power. This is a little papule on the face of a kid, and it has a little infiltrate here. And looking closer, man, that reminds me a lot, or at least it did at the time, of mastocytosis. It looks a lot like mastocytosis, which we'll talk about in a minute. And it's kind of filling up the papillary dermis, but not involving the epidermis over top. And the cells kind of have an almost grainy look, grainy to bubbly maybe, sometimes it's hard to tell. And there are EOs here, which there can be in mast cell disease. But when I did a stain, this was negative for mast cell markers like CD117 and tryptase, and positive for, I think, CD68 or something. So this is what is when JXG is early, an early JXG, when it's first kind of developing, tends to be mononuclear histiocytes with a little bit of foamy cytoplasm, but tends to not have well-developed Teuton giant cells yet, or some of the other features. And because of that, the kind of uniformity of it can make it look a lot like a mastocytoma, I think. Now, in contrast, this is an example of a mastocytoma or you know, urticaria pigmentosa form of mastocytosis could look like this, depends on the clinical. But you can see kind of similar. These do have cytoplasm texture is different. These are really kind of a finely granular cytoplasm because of the little mast cell granules that can contain histamine and tryptase. But I think I said that wrong. Histamine and what's the other thing in the mast cell granules? I'm blanking. The one that vasodilate. I don't know. In any case, I'll come back later and edit it out, or I'll just leave it in there and people can realize that I forget stuff every day. So in any case, though, you can even see a couple little EOs in there, okay? But look, there is a little difference, but they look kind of similar. I thought so. Somehow this one is a little bit pixelated, but